The first thing I think when I'm asked to be on camera is, will I be represented properly? Will I be taken out of context? That's huge to me. And every time I talk to someone in the film industry, I already am concerned. I'm already worried.
So they made it seem like I believed in the voodoo shark and that it existed.
Not only is that dishonest, you're messing with that guy's career.
But you have to understand, from our perspective, we need a scientist to say it's real. That's the story. They said, well, then it's not a documentary, that you're doing a work of fiction.
Then they called back and said, well, you know, it got picked up for another season. We'd really like to have you. And I said, I feel like I was mischaracterized on your show. I'm not happy about that.
They chose just to use the first part of the interview and not use the part where I'm talking about an explanation, which is grounded in reality, and just leave it open-ended, like, okay, it could have been a monster.
If you don't care what I'm saying, if you don't care that I'm an expert on these things that I've written books about, then why am I here? Don't turn me into a liar.
So there I was watching the premiere broadcast, and I see myself saying the words that I had said, but with the framing removed and left me just saying this old disproven idea that I actually don't accept.
None of these are based on any science or anything that scientists have said. These are all completely false.
That's the most extreme example that I know of. They outright manipulated those interviews and those edits, and it's dramatic.
This paper doesn't say that at all. COVID-19 did not exist when this paper was written.
And therefore, if the news or the, you know, the newspapers get it wrong, the public is going to be misled very, very rapidly.